Okay, thank you, Mayor. I'm not gonna sing, by the way. And I have to stand here so I'm not blocking the screen, it's not gonna catch me. So, just a couple of things. Over the last several weeks, we've been discussing what the implications of the township are of changes in the cap requirements that have been discussed very publicly at the state level by the governor and by the legislature. We have been tracking that very closely for a few months now, and we actually have prepared some very detailed financial information to back it up. And it was just too much to fit on the back of the napkin. So we actually did a very full report on it. I wanted to share that with you tonight. One of the developments over the weekend that's very important to recognize is that the New Jersey legislature with the governor came to a deal on what the caps will be going forward, and that's been published in the newspaper. So that over the weekend what we did is we updated this such that Brandon will present the most current information we have and what the implications are for the township of Nutley. This was something that I could have presented to the commissioners, but and then in a two-step process, but I think the information is very fresh, very relevant. At least that we start having these conversations now, maybe sooner rather than later. So with that, Sally, you're going to flip questions. Thank you. So we've talked about this from time to time, and raised it at different points, but we never actually put it all together to actually create a picture of what's happening in Nutley, given the environment that we're in. And we all know that assessed values of our properties have gone down. From on average, $413,000 down to $351,000 in the last year. We've also are well aware of the fact that state aid has gone down. Right? And so we've lost state aid, which was at $1.1 million, it's now down to $250,000. It's currently at $450,000 today, so we're expecting to lose another $200,000. So substantially, the state is not giving us any aid going forward, and that's a challenge for us. At the same time, we've actually seen our ongoing trend with salaries and including longevity and allowances continue to rise. We've seen significant increases in pension costs. We've seen significant increases in health care costs. We now have contribution towards that, but it's not enough because it's offset the rate of rise. And when you look at all the other expenses, they haven't been growing at such a rate to be managed. So they're going to be within the limits. And what's important about this slide is that I'm not talking about the total tax bill. The municipality only represents 35% of the tax bill. You have to add to it 48% more for the school board and another 17% to cover the county. So when a taxpayer gets their full bill, the part that the municipality has the direct ability to influence is roughly 35% of that bill. And when we say these assessed values have gone down, they've gone down on average because when you go and you assess, some go up, some go down. Okay? So the reality is that this gives you a pretty good picture of what's happening in the town from a financial standpoint.
That's interesting.
Next one. So with this, we have to accept some very important facts. The simple reality is that no taxpayers need to leave. The economic environment is such that people are still suffering. Small business has not turned around. Alan Greenspan was talking about that just on Thursday of this week. We've seen that the fact is that while assessed values on average are $351,000, the average total tax on that household is now at $9,800 and rising. And so we're seeing that the annual increases that we've been seeing that are generally over $200 per household just fall into a category of being too high and unaffordable. So with the new state cap, there's a simple fact that the way we've done business historically changes going forward. There's no room to actually think about some of the things that have been part of our thinking about compensation packages, the way we spend money. It's tightened up so to such to the point that a couple of things are really important. While the cap is at 2%, the legislature still excluded health care and pension. So for municipality, two of the areas where our costs are rising at a very significant rate are now outside the cap and will continue to drive increases in taxes for those two items. And recognize that there's contributions being made by employees to these pensions. There's also now healthcare contributions being made. Those costs are still rising at a significant rate and at an alarming rate in spite of that. The other thing that's really important is that without concessions, our historical compensation practices will result in terminations. Not if, not the potential when, what might we do to exclude you? Terminations will be part of the assumption unless they are changed. And what's more is, as a commission body, we're also concerned about the level of services that we can provide. Other aspect of this, our compensation plan, when we talk about compensation from a financial standpoint, you have to include everything. It's not just the overnight increase. You have to include base pay. You have to include longevity pay. You have to include holiday pay. You have to include stipends, and you have to include allowances, because they all add to the cost, and all of those are included in the 2%. So if you think about all of the cost of all of those, they can't rise more than 2%. So think about that, and then the challenge of that. The other aspect is a lot of the assumptions that are here, right? When you go back 30, 40, 50 years, the model was basically low base pay with great benefits. And you got other things for doing more, right? We've evolved since then. We've evolved significantly since then. So they were no longer in a low pay, great benefits environment. For many, we're in a great pay, great benefits environment. And this an environment, both the economic environment as well as the state caps and success. In fact, the real challenge is that we have to think differently about how we use this going forward. So, just to recap from the state perspective, state legislature and the governor have agreed on a 2% annual cap, which maintains exceptions for health care, pension, energy, and debt service payments. Health care and pension are the most significant numbers to think about in terms of that calculation. The other aspect of it is that they preserve. The fact is that if we want to exceed the cap, we will have to go through a public referendum, in fact, a public vote to exceed it. So the taxpayers are not able to vote on whether or not we exceed that cap. The other things that are still pending, but there's a lot of momentum around it, is a very clear thing, is that civil service will become an option if we want to remain in civil service, and there's an improved flexibility around how we look at furlough and the application of furlough days. And actually, and the other thing is pending, which is a lot of momentum, and again, is that binding arbitration will have to consider the 2% cap and all sources of income as part of it. So the nature of negotiation is changing. Then, from a perspective, this, just to put this all in perspective, right, this lower red bar represents the monies that we receive in terms of what we call revenue. That comes from grant monies we receive, state aid, fines for things or fees that we do, and the application of our reserves or surplus. Right? And as you can see, that trend has been actually substantially flat and slightly declining. What's important about this slide is that after you apply all that, the amount of money that must be raised in the tax levy and taxes from our taxpayers is rising. And when you think about that, the important part about that is that 80% of the taxes that are paid against that come from a residential taxpayer. 18% of those taxpayers are senior citizens, and the median income is roughly about $60,000. So when you think about it, is that for a town of our size, we've been talking about for a very long time affordability, and affordability is a reality. Now the cap, where do we stand with the cap? When you look at the cap, with the exceptions for healthcare, pension, energy, debt service, right, the amount that we will be allowed to increase our levy will rise from its current $36.8 million to $41.4 million by 2012. What this means is, based on the current assumptions, which is for the fire contract that's in place, police proposal that's on the table, potential retirements that have been considered, the application of the 1.5 contribution for a health care, the increases in pension, and so on.